I guess it was way easier to get Game of Orc games versus suicidal vermin. This should be in it. Okay, so I'm first. Yes. Okay, so I'm trying to keep track of if I actually, if the higher team value gets to do things first, and it seems to be the case at the moment. The blood voice of Abe. That's pretty obvious. Hopefully the audio is the audio levels are fine. Otherwise, you guys in stream chat has to shout at me. Ah, oh, it's possibly raining. Game of Orcs versus Suicidal Vermin, Zombie number 7. So that's 4 Gutter Runners. That means there's probably not going to be a Rat Ogre, which is good for our troll. Now I just have to remember if we have any tackle. I don't think we do. I'm going to go on offense. I will golf and hoof. Slink has nothing. I don't think they would have anything because it's a looked like it was a fresh team. No, they don't have anything. What do we have? Nothing. Nothing. Guard. Guys, we've got guard on Frustrated Orc. We got minus agility and guess who? It's an orc. And Castle Raven Lork managed to. Mighty Blow on Don't Wake War Boss. Well, that's nice. And I think that's pretty much. Yeah, that's what we've got. And we are apparently out. We're out the thrower, I guess. So it's Proto Greek Orc that's going to be the ball carrier here, I think. Especially considering there are 4 gutter runners on the other team, and I don't want the goblins to have to deal with that. Well, I mean, they could be the ball carrier, but I think I'd rather use one of the blitzers. Am I going to play Fallout 4? I think I'm going to get it and start playing it. I like Fallout 3. It's the type of game where I don't have time to finish it. I think my thrower's missed next in this one. But yeah, I'm looking forward to Fallout 4. The problem with having a partnership and a YouTube channel is that you kind of like you judge everything based on should I be streaming this or should I be playing it offline? Because as soon as you're playing something just for yourself, you're like, but I could be playing this for people instead, which is a really weird feeling. It's there once, so that's a slight mistake from my opponent in that. One of his pieces are they're too far ahead, and for that reason I am gonna move these guys up here, because if I do get a quick snap I can move people around. And that's why I left this goblin here, because these guys can unstep this way if they want. Come on, give me quick snap just to show why you shouldn't be standing here. I am kind of sad that we only have two rerolls. Okay, here we go. Kick. Aww. Actually, changing weather nice is really good for me. Because it means I can possibly pick the ball up. Which is something I love being able to do. Okay. Let's see here. You've got nothing. You've got nothing. I think we're going to start here then. Oh, that's a good start. Nothing happened, but still. Let's see. Yeah, we are going to base these guys here. I think I want to try and do this. Yeah, let's do that. Oh, sweet. Success. Worked out. Oh no, that's a mistake. No, hang on, I can fix this. Okay, cool. Phew. Because I don't want this guy to be the bolt carrier. I want Puerto Greek Orc, but I moved Puerto Greek Orc up here, which I shouldn't have, of course. But he can still move back and do good stuff. Let's see. Oh, well, would you look at that? Let's see how this goes. Pretty well. I'm okay with this. I thought about moving him further up here, but they can remove this piece by assist and assist here. And then this dude, someone could blitz in, which I didn't want. So, we didn't get that much done, but we do have a very strong line here. Oh, that's unfortunate for him. It's really good for me, though. That's good enough, but it does mean that there's no good path through here. Now, there wouldn't be been anyways because of this guy and everything else. So, all things considered, I'm pretty pleased with the results. I think I'm going to try and move this cage up into the middle here. If I can. We'll see where the rest is going. These goblins aren't really here to assist, like, This piece is here mostly to add more tackle zones here, making it like harder to get in here. Because I'm kind of like, if you want to blitz this guy, fine. I can't really stop that. I have three pieces that are strength two, so my main goal is always going to be to make sure that the blitz doesn't happen on this piece. And worst case scenario, I'll just block people. Like, I don't mind. I mean, I want to grind against this team a bit. Because we're orcs. They're Skaven. Also, not covering this orc is interesting. But then again, he kind of wants me to score quickly, probably. So I just need to make sure that I'm going to run this guy back. I'm going to follow here. Oh, that's nice. We'll follow here too. And then we'll move this piece up here. Because now we're changing the position of the cage. Let's see. I think... No, I want to use this. What do you have? I think we do this. I think we use... actually, we shouldn't have used a reroll there. But it's fine. So, rather than... Because I wanted someone to base this piece. But if I use this guy, it's essentially like... He'll be out of position, and this guy can pretty easily dodge out anyways. But now he's slightly blocking this side. This piece can just run in here and blitz. And... or get some assists here and remove this piece. But I'm still pretty okay with this. My point is still just to try and get... I mean, I want to get as many blocks on these rats as possible. And it seems like my opponent has slightly shifted focus into screening rather than trying to attack the cage. Which... What is going on, Thursday? How are you doing, cat? Yeah, so... Wow. Okay. Thursday's very interested in my new new desk lamp. I have to make sure that don't. Okay, good. Well, that is unfortunate, but not unexpected. I'm not going to say it was part of the plan, but it was, like I said. I kind of expected it to happen. And this blighter, this lineman, doesn't have both down, so he only knocked this piece down on an actual round. Oh, that's nice. Because that means we now get to do... Let's see. So that's 1-6. Yeah. We get to do this. Unfortunately, that didn't really do much. But that's okay. We have other important stuff that we need to do. Oh, hang on. My computer making weird noises with the fans because I have to replace them. I could... No. Okay. That's nice. I should have pushed him there instead. That was a, kind of a mistake. But he got stunned, so I'm okay with it. Okay, so that's good. Now this is a problem. Or can I? If this had been super duper serious, I wouldn't have blocked here. Because 1-6, this guy loses tackle zones, and then my opponent can get in here. But I'm less worried because I can do this. Which makes sense then. Yeah, okay, good. So that means I can allow myself to do this. And now this dude is, because we shifted over, this guy's also kind of stuck. Because, well, not super duper stuck, but slightly. Let's see, where do I want this piece? Probably here. So we're taking it really slow, and we're grinding because we're up against rats. But we'll see what happens. I mean, I do want, okay, so he's going to blitz. Well, that would be a dodge, but he might use this piece, because I don't think anyone else can reach. This guy can dodge out and blitz here, but he doesn't need the assist to do that. It is a dodge, unless they do a one die block here first, which is the same failure rate as the dodge. No, it's actually worse. No, it's the same. We'll soon find out. Let's see, I haven't injured any of them, I've just stunned them. Nope. Oh, he... Okay, that was kind of... Well... Okay, so the blitz is still around. I think that was a pretty smart... I don't know. Like, it freed up this piece, but then what's this piece going to do? Apparently... Okay. And unfortunately that works out. Now, this piece can dodge in here, which is a smart move. While he's going to be standing at, it's a smart move. We'll soon find out. No, go this way. Go this way. There we go. Much easier. Okay, are you gonna run all the way around here, or where are you gonna stand? Okay, you're gonna stand there. Interesting. Yeah. You do not get to run, so I have a troll. Okay. So, we can start by pushing this piece away. And that was actually kind of the best result we could have gotten there, because... This means that this... actually, I could have just stayed otherwise. So it's still fine. He gets to stand up. Oh, okay. That's bad. Oof. I will follow. Oh! Well, that's nice. I don't think he's... No. No, let me select someone else, thank you. There we go, that's nice. You go. I won't. You will stay put. Go stand over there instead. You will stand over there. I do not like this setup. Hang on. What are we? Oh, okay. Go stand here instead. Oh, right. Okay. That's slightly better. Okay. Now you go over there. I'm gonna stay put. Bonk. That's the end of my turn. This is a weird ass looking cage, but he can clear this guy out, but that's not gonna help him. He can blitz this piece away, possibly. Well, he would, but with the gut runners. But now I'm feeling pretty good about the fact that most of the rats over here in the position I'm going, there aren't any. They're all back here, which is good for me. It's not that often you outrun rats, but if you put yourself in a position where your guys are actually between them and where the ball is going, things are thumbs up kind of ish. Okay, so this partly seems like zombie number 7 here just is going to run all of his people. Well, okay, so that guy's going to get blocked down. But it's going to run most of the pieces over this way, which means I get to reform my cage like somewhere really nice. Hopefully. Managed to knock him down. I have to be slightly more careful now where I do my blocks in what order, because I am out of rerolls. And oh no, Smork up! What happened? Main reason I did that is because I'm kind of, and this is a ballsy move by me, I'm not expecting most of the other pieces to be injured. Sure, the goblins. I don't care about the goblins. That's fine. But a niggle on an orc is never good. Okay, it just isn't. Oh, that's a dodge. We don't want to do that. Oh, he doesn't really need to be there. Okay. Oh, I can do... Okay, yeah, that's smart. You go over here. Now I have a piece here, so now I can do this slightly riskier bit. I'm going to do this first, though. Oh! Get out, cloak. And even if I fall down here... Oh, I didn't. And this guy's just here to block this piece from running straight through. Let's see. Yeah, so we have one out. There are three rats out. Neither of us have any... Yeah. So this is if he goes for the goblin, I am okay with that because it means I can surf that piece possibly. I was tempted to foul, but I'm down one now, and it kind of depends on what happens next half. I don't want to be down more pieces because the rats are so fast. So if one of these goblins get ejected, I also have less people to throw around. Hi, Thursday. Must be kind of weird to watching this just to me randomly say hi Thursday. That's because Thursday's on my desk being annoyed at me that I'm not petting her enough. Okay, so it seems... Why are you putting two pieces here? Are you gonna go around this way? Or are you... Oh. I guess we'll find out soon enough. Oh. Did not go for the goblin. Well, went for a goblin, not the one I expected. This is probably the better move. But it does make me slightly sad. Okay. Ooh, well, that's nice. Two rerolls left, turn five. Do you reroll? I guess you do. Okay. Stay here. Hmm. Do I want to do anything? Ooh. Well, that's nice. Okay, so that kinda works out. Oh, it did super work out. Good. Well, almost. So I thought about pushing forward even further, but I'm up against rats. This is going to be slightly tricky coming up. But I... Like, if I score on turn 7, or in this case, turn 6, the rats are just going to score on me. So I kind of have to score on turn 8. They have a reroll left, and I kind of, like, I'm expect like, 2-turn touchdown for 4 gutter runners. That's not hard. Let's see, how many are out? 3. So that means there are 8. 2, 4. Yes, 8. So... Well, that's unfortunate for me. But at least it was the... At least it was the Storm Vermin moving around, which is good. Because Storm Vermin is way more useful than any of the other players. Well, not the Gutturners, of course. But when it comes to stealing my ball, they're not that great. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I kind of want to... I want to end up at least here. On turn 7. That might be tricky. But we're going to give it a go. I think we're just going to have to put our big stinking... well... You're welcome, yay 1H. It's a pretty solid podcast. He's talking about my Swedish bad movie podcast, Tveksamt. But unless you understand Swedish, you're not going to be enjoying it much. If you do, you should check it out at tveksamt.com. Okay. This is... Okay. Let's see. That means... Okay, I mean, this is... This is not that bad, because it means... Yeah, there's a 2-die block here, but there's no blitz on this piece. Okay. You probably don't want to do that, but I highly suggest that you do. Ooh, this, because of this, this might clear a path for me to run and go stand over here. Which would be real good. I guess we'll see with this guy. I don't think this guy's going anywhere. Okay, that makes this move slightly more dangerous. So we might just push up on this side instead. Okay, oh, that's nice. You go stand over there, and then stay put. No, I can't GFI this. I would love to, but I'm out of rerolls, and if this guy falls down, it's going to be a problem, because these guys can just dodge out and blitz my ball carrier. Yeah, this troll has been amazingly well behaved so far. I'm glad I managed to move this far up, because it means that if I get blocked here, I have some horizontal movement. Like, I can go all the way over, like, here. And because these guys are here, they should be able to clear a path, possibly. I think the best option, just looking at who's standing up, I think if the rats want to stop me from scoring, the best option they have is to just, like, blitz in one of the gutter runners. Because it's only two tackle zones here, so it's dodging out and then hoping that both of them are knockdowns. You should save this game, or at least this half, for tutorials on how to play Bash versus Fast. We yet to see a non-Hadwick community member play Bash ball carry, right? I mean, it's maybe like it, this is probably going up on YouTube, so I guess people can learn that way. I think one of the things I have a hard time with at the moment when I'm working on the Blood Bowl guides is that it's hard to judge what's considered, like, obvious information and what's actually, oh, that's how that works kind of thing. Because at the moment, I'm like, oh, everything's really, like, everyone knows this, right? What? Hi, cat. Aww. Okay, so what he could do, my opponent here, is he could use this guy, stand this guy up, remove this dude, push him back, and then this dodge would be easier. Because now it's a 3+ into a 2+. Or that can happen. So that's a reroll. And that's a touchdown for me. But maybe he wanted to use this for something else. Can you recruit a non-Blood Bowl person to be confused about things? I guess I could. But most of my my friends that don't play Blood Bowl, they were confused when it came to Blood Bowl Chaos Edition, so I've already used them up. We're just going to run in and score. Okay, I totally missed what happened. Okay, three are still KO'd, which is good. Everyone gets to run back for the last turn. It needs to be symmetrical. I need to fix this. There we go. Fixed. Okay, so that was actually really good. This troll is still looking for one more injury, so you can level up again. But I think one of my blitzers, right? Yep, Predator Greek Orc, who used to be Armbold Carry and Bloodbold Chaos Edition, managed to level up, so that's really nice. I already tried to teach Jesse Cox Blood Bowl once. It did not go well. I did have a lovely time trying giving Dodger some tips for the Blood Bowl Chaos Edition one. If you roll double, you should be able to get leap on a troll. Okay, kick. Here we go. Changing weather. Nice. Okay, so seems like they're gonna block down both of my black works, which, all things considered, is probably the best option that could have happened for me. We'll see how badly it hurts in a bit. Okay, good. We did what we had to do in the first half. We stopped the rats from running around, and we had a nice secure ball for most of it. I haven't tried Overwatch yet. I'm not in the beta. But it might be possibly fun. The pass is good! Aw, damn it. Two of them came back. So we're even on players. Oh. I have to do it the other way around. Now, I'd love to leave, like, this isn't good enough because the gutter runners can get through. I have to do this. Because against rats, I don't want to leave a hole. Like, I could just move everything in, but I don't want to do that because the rats are just going to run through really quickly. And I'm not... Rather, I don't have enough fast pieces to catch up with the gut runners. Ogre Watch 100%. So we'll see how. Ooh, Goblin should probably score a touchdown just so I have a Goblin with some SPPs. Who's out? It's just a. Oh, it's actually one of the gut runners. Okay, that's actually good then. Why not put him directly to the side of Goblin? Because if I do, he's one step forward, and he won't be able to reach as far back. And also, he can get surfed. If I put him here, he can get, well, not against this team, but he can be trapped by the sidelines. So it's more of a never put someone here kind of thing. And if I put him here, of course, they can run through by on the side. I don't like having all of my pieces on one line, because it means the rats can all reach them, and the opposite is true. Like if by having that formation on the side, I have an easier time to, frenzy. Well, not frenzy, but surf someone. If someone goes to stand here, I can go, blop blop. But I can't do that if I have them next to each other and someone stands here, because then. It wouldn't be a surf. Oh, I'm running out of tea. Meaning, well, in my cup, not in my pot. Okay, this is interesting, because this is going to be a two die block here. So, I'm impressed that he decides, or she decides to go for this straight away. But we'll see. The goblin's in front of the black orc, because if the goblin was here, my opponent could just use a blitzer to blitz from the side here and get two die and push the goblin back and then have the gutturners run through. By having the black orc here, that's not possible. And while this is still blitzable, probably not going to get blitzed. Okay, I don't know what happened here. This would have been a 2-die if someone had taken care... Well, no, guard. So it would never have been a 2-die. But if this piece didn't have guard, it could have been. If someone was standing here rather than here. I don't know why that happened, though. Like, I don't know what the plan was, because... Even if, say this piece gets knocked down, like right here, it doesn't open up a path, and it doesn't stop a threat in any way. I guess what it does do is free up this piece. Okay, let's see if the ball gets picked up. How far can you... Okay, you can run over here. But I'm guessing you want to possibly go stand here then? Okay. Are you gonna run forward and pass back to this piece? Is that what's happening? Or are you just gonna pick it up with this piece and run it back? Because that's a pretty sneaky move. Because I'm not really that fast. That seems to be the plan here. Because otherwise, why is this piece back here? Oh shit, I should have had... If only I had a goblin by the troll, could have shucked him. I mean, I can run the troll back here, but the snook can be... The throw is probably not going to be far enough. Could just surf this guy. That's the thing I could do. Okay, so now we have a goblin here. Let's do it. No! Does this matter? No. No enough. I was like, oh, I'm going to surf that guy. But then I was like, no, two rerolls. It's not good enough. The thing you kind of have to... Yeah, so the thing you have to watch out for are... Like, the Scatterrunner that can move forward. I have this in the back, but he can be covered by, like, someone else. Just going to stand next to him. But at least now I have... Well, that's probably not going to happen. That I have to throw... this goblin, because tackle zone's here, but still. The first tabletop team I painted was Orcs, and they had gray armor with blood splatter all over them. So that's my suggestion if you want it for a painting scheme. It's a... Oh, okay. So, you know what? I'm pretty okay. Like, this is not that bad for me in a way. But yeah, so the Gutrunner can move forward. This piece is free. And it's not going to get blocked by anyone, probably. So I can run around and blitz here next turn. This guy is not going to move forward because it's scary. These guys might dodge. Yeah. Going to dodge away. Nope. Oh, shit. Can I? I don't think I can reach. Can I? And this guy gets to be the roadblock. Okay, not exactly what I wanted, but because this guy's stunned, now everything's kind of concentrated over here, which is... I am totally fine with. I have to do this then. So it goes. Ooh, it went well. Because I have Mighty Blow. Let's see what happens. Good things happened. Another stun. Very nice. Oh. Finally decided to really stupid. But that means this goblin, unfortunately, have to go stand over here. No, I do not do that. Because if he wants to go block goblins, I'm, for the most part, okay with that. Everyone is still... Let's see. These two are not based. Yeah, this guy is kind of tricky to see, but the troll did have someone telling him what to do. He just rolled a one. But that does give me some extra time to pet my cat. Have a Thursday. Don't use your claws. But it seems like... So there aren't really enough there's no rat that can score this turn because I managed to stun both of the available gut runners. Of course, this is a gut runner here in the back as well. And one of them still KO'd. So there's no one really to hand it off to. And while I didn't really push forward, I do have pieces that in theory can get over there next turn. If need be. This guy can run over to give an assist. And then my goblin here can blitz in and possibly knock down the gut runner as an option. So we'll see what happens. Okay. Oh, okay. Running further away. Interesting. That probably means I do have to use this goblin to threaten next turn. Actually, depending on what happens here, I can just if these guys Okay, he should push me over here. Oh, he didn't. Nice. And he shouldn't follow up here. This is kind of important. Because if he does, this guy has exactly. So I can clear this piece off and I'd have to blitz this piece off and then I could throw a goblin down there. Which might actually be I think it's worth it at this point. Okay, now this guy can block this goblin. Nope, no, that went really well for him. No. Goblin, no! What happened to him? Oh, well, he's dead. That's unfortunate. Is he gonna do the one die here? Okay. I'm sorry, Thursday, I have to stop petting you now because I have important business to take care of. Okay, so... Oh, that's no good. Okay, so that's really bad. Or, well... In all, like, it could, like, it didn't go well, but there's still, like, the gut runners are up again. But they can't score this turn. What's the harm in keeping the goblin around? He got minus armor value, so he'd just get knocked out. So that means all of these three are free to move. We'll just have to see how this progresses. Oh, that's nice. That doesn't knock down my goblin. I will dodge. And this guy still covers most of this. Like, this dude can't run down. So that's good. Okay. Like if I can just get rid of this guy, I can throw the goblin next turn. Which would be pretty sweet. Okay, so that frees up this thrower. Where are you going with him? Okay, I mean... Well, that's... Are you gonna follow up? Please follow up. It's very good, you guys. Very good. Well, maybe very good is a bit of a strong word, but it's good. We'll see how well it works shortly. Where are you going to go, a Dutch runner? Oh. Well, that's a shame. Now I don't have to throw you anywhere. Yeah, okay. Okay, yeah, I can reach that. Oh, I totally forgot he was in Okay, here we go. What? You snake-eyed the first thing you did? Shit, he got- No, you didn't. Phew. Okay. You 2-1. I'll allow it. So what needs to happen is probably this dude blitzes this guy, and then there's going to be a pass here. That leaves me 3 turns. Or he just dodges out. Does a handoff here? No. A That sounds good. A snake with a monocle. Yeah, pretty much. Oh! No! Yeah, I've been there. Do I have... Oh, actually, no, okay. We're gonna do this first. Thank you. Yes! Get out, Skulk. Oh, that sucks. Oh, that's good. That's an apple. Hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're just gonna do this. We're also gonna reroll that because we have 3 die. That's not good enough. But can do that. No, I did. Damn it. Like the wrong thing. Ah, that was not smart. Let's see. Yeah, you are in scoring position. No. I'm not going to lock there. My other option would have been to block this piece. Well, he got stupid. But if I managed to block this piece away, I could have removed this piece too. No, I'd have to block this piece away so that this guy is free because he was here. And then I could have gone 1, 2, 3, 4, assuming this piece was knocked down. 5, 6, bomb, bomb. But that didn't happen. Okay, so this is a smart move because it's essentially blocking Don't Wake War Boss from doing anything. Hang on. What's your... No, you're at 10. Oh, are you doing a handoff here now? You are. Interesting. Okay, so that worked. But if you dodge out, then you're not going to be able to score. So you need to dodge for, yeah. This might be a tie. Oh, it's gonna, oh. Damn it. This piece needs to, yeah, need to block here. So I'm like, Now my options are, I can use this goblin to just blitz, but that's a one die, and this piece is only knocked down on a 5+, on a both down, and on a pow. But if I get a both down, then all of these people around should be able to possibly run in and pick it up and score. So, that's not the bestest plan. The other option is to go stand over here and hope to get dodge out and blitz this piece, which is incidentally what I'm going to do. Okay, so that's a shame, because I'd love to get this piece down here to block these guys, but I can't do that right now because he's in a tackle zone and I don't have any rerolls. So, we are just going to do this and see how well it works. Not. Because I rolled a one. but, this is a... I still have one shot because I have three goblins and a troll on turn 16. So basically all that needs to happen now is for this Storm Vermin to blitz and push this piece away. But if we get more skulls, then yay, I guess. Not enough skulls. I mean, the other hope we have is that my opponent Krendor's it for no good reason. Because all that's left to do is run in. He didn't Krendor it. I'm not going to set up my team. He needs to set up his team first game. Actually, I only have two goblins left. Because one of them got real injured, you guys. That's actually two orcs injured. And only one... No, it's three orcs injured and one rat injured. Getting outbashed by the rats. But to be fair to the rats, I think we have the same amount of block. Yeah, we do. Hmm. Okay, let's see what we got here. I don't need that call to be on the line. Oh. Okay, so let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, I think I do dare to have this goblin here. It means it's one further away to do a handoff, but I'm okay with that, I think. It's all up to the ball now. Oh, we got a reroll. Oh! Okay. Kaboink. No, you. Okay, he fit. That did not go according to plan. Oh! But then I just ruined that guy instead. You can't vanity throw teammate as a pass action, so I used my pass action, so I couldn't do a vanity pass. Okay. Oh! Frustrated Orc just got the MVP. That is excellent news. No, that's the wrong team. That's not the team I want to look at. I want to look at... Oh, I'm glad this is so streamlined. Okay, so this guy, we're gonna... Hang on, this guy we're gonna fire. Okay. Level up this troll. Aww. Did not get what we needed him to get. So we can give him stand firm. We could give him break tackle. We're not going to give him juggernaut because juggernaut is, as we know, busted. I could give him strong arm. Storm, if he had strong arm, he wouldn't have failed that, is the thing. No, not, I think, Like, it's either grab or stand firm. Damn it. It could give him piling on. Oh, everyone's like strong armor break tackle. Fuck it. We're playing with... If anything, we need to keep buying goblins now. What? Yeah, okay. I'm never gonna say no to agility. Besides, Praetor Greek Orc is our bolt carrier. So, that's a thing now. What is your problem, Borkamon? Oh, you have a niggle. Okay, but we... And what's your problem, Smorkup? You're just missed next, right? Yeah. Should buy a player. And that player should be a goblin. So I need a good suggestion for a goblin board game thing, but that doesn't have to be for YouTube. Goodbye, YouTube.